Today, you're going to learn how to deal with difficult times in life. Now today, actually, we brought on board my Vegas emerging coach, Ray Bayne, to pick his brain about his topic. I'm warning you right now though, this isn't some watered down mainstream, you can do this kind of bullshit. We're gonna actually make you get out of your bed and go do shit. My name is Brian Choi, and on this channel, we help you dominate your social, dating, and networking lives. What you can expect is some of the things that I've learned so far in my own journey, and secondhand mentorship from some of the most influential figures in the field. So if you want to be part of the tribe, hit the subscribe button right now. So Ray's gonna say a couple words, and let's dive in right now.
Yo, what up guys? Ray here, Brian's the man. On this topic, we wanna talk about the mindset when going through struggles. It's perfectly normal to go through struggles in life. You can't avoid it. For one thing, you don't want to avoid it, because if you avoid it, you're not learning. When you're struggling, that's when you learn the most. The failures, the setbacks. Whenever you feel like shit, that's when you're gonna pause, you're gonna reflect, and you're gonna be like, damn, shouldn't have done that. So the mindset for me is you gotta be positive. Reframe everything to the point where it's like you're delusional. So for example, I'm going in between apartments right now. Because I'm going through this struggle, I know for a fact that this is making me tougher, so the next time this ever happens, I'll be fine, I can cruise right through it. And what's really cool is it's kind of like the world's testing you. If you can get through these tests, if you can get through these hard times, these struggles, you're gonna create a new threshold for yourself. For example, this can be like a threshold of discomfort. You're getting uncomfortable, but you stay under here long enough, you're gonna rise, you're gonna break through it. Whatever this was gets raised. So then you can take a lot more, you can struggle a lot more and not set back, and you're not gonna be discouraged. Successful people in general, they go through so many setbacks, but it doesn't faze them because they've experienced it before, they've got the reference experience, and so they know how to handle it. And because they know how to handle it, it's no longer negative, it's just another challenge. Reframe struggles into opportunities, then that word just leaves your vocabulary. That's the mindset. One little thing to get over it is to take massive, massive action. That's so cliche, fucking do it, because I said so. I'm a random person, trust me. That's it from me, back to you, man.
So obviously, what Ray said are all correct. But if you're watching this video right now, because you searched on YouTube, how to deal with difficult times or how to get through tough times, then you may not even be able to relate with some of the things Ray said so far. They kind of make sense on the surface layer, but it's like, okay, you feel kind of comforted listening to this, but you can't, like, it really doesn't make you get out of bed and go do shit. But you may have already heard all this shit from like Tony Robbins, RC Max, RC Tyler, Gary Vaynerchuk, like everyone's telling you to like take massive action, go out and do shit, all that. But it just doesn't make sense because you're just fucking depressed or sad or you're going through shit right now. So we're not gonna sit here and be another Shia LaBeouf and be like, just do it, go do shit. Like, you know, I think you've gotten already enough motivation. You're probably searching Google and YouTube like hundreds of times, like watching all those motivational videos, but it didn't really help you. It's like you feel comforted, like someone's trying to cheer you up or like it makes sense. If you're in self-help right now, then you may already know all these things, like go take massive action. Don't be victim mentality, all those things. But, you know, it's just not gonna make sense. In Way of the Wolf by Jordan Belfort, phenomenal book, he talks about how human beings, psychologically, like emotions will only like motivate you for only a few hours at a time. Like it's just how it is. And motivation and encouragement, they're only motivation. So it's not gonna like sustain you for a long time. If you have a lot of anger in you right now, use that as fuel. Yes, use it as like initial training wheel to get the ball rolling. This helps. I've done it before. This really works. But if you're more on the sad side and like you're more depressed and like, then it's just not gonna work because you're more like down low and like your energy levels are low. So I'm gonna tell you one thing that has helped me in the past and I keep going back to whenever I need to. This knowing your why. Yes, fucking cliche, I know. If you're in personal development, if you're in self-help, you've heard this hundreds of times. But there's a reason why it's cliche. It's because it fucking works and you gotta know your why. Like, what is the reason that you're doing all the things that you're doing right now? Why do you need to make more money? Why do you need to meet more girls? Why do you need to make more cool friends? Why do you need to get better in shape? You gotta know the reasons. It's kind of like reverse engineering. Like, if you don't know the reasons that if you don't reverse engineer, then you're just gonna burn out on like step two, you know, on like day five. You're kind of just gonna burn out because you're trying to like get to like the next step. Okay, what's the next step? I don't know, what's the next step? Okay, I do this, I do that. Like, you gotta know your why. Like, why are you doing this? why? Just think about that. Like, pause this video for a moment and just think to yourself, like, why do I need to do this? Why am I doing this? Me, for example, right? My why I need to be better in game, success with women, and be more confident, be more grounded, and better networking is because it's not about me anymore. Like, initially it was about me. Obviously, like, I'm this like horny little kid. I wanna like fuck everything that walks. I'm like, you know, I have no friends. I wanna make more friends. And those motives still stay inside me, right? But at the same time, lately what I've been realizing, like making these videos and putting up on social media, Instagram, Facebook, now I'm getting these messages from people I've never met around the world. Like, recently I've been getting messages about, like, from like Asian guys that are in a different part of the world. They're messaging me things like, hey bro, I love the fact that there's an Asian guy somewhere in the world that is crushing it right now. Thank you so much for the inspiration. You give me courage, you give me more confident. Thank you so much. And when I hear that, I'm obviously like humbled, you know? I'm not like an expert, and I'm not like killing the game right now, per se. But just the fact that there are people watching me, and the fact that people can draw inspiration from me and get help from me, then that fucking drives me. That's my why now. Like, I need to be the role model. I need to be that excuse or that shield so that other Asian guys can look up to me and say, yeah, like, I don't have to be another like comedic Asian character from like another Hollywood movie. I can be more confident. I can be more attractive. I can meet more attractive women. I can be like a high status male. Like, the Asian stereotypes don't matter. And if I can provide that, I can provide the reasons, then that's my fucking why. Like, that keeps me going. Even when I'm tired, even when I'm like not feeling my best, even when I wake up on the wrong side of my bed, I still get up and I force myself to edit more videos, shoot these videos, write down my next video. Things like that. This keeps me going. But here's a twist. It doesn't end here. A lot of people will just say, like, you gotta know the why and that's it. No, that's not it. There's more. You gotta know the how now. Now that you have the internal reasons why you're doing it and why you need to do it, you gotta know the how, like the roadmap, like how are you gonna do it? So how do you know the how? You see, we now live in such an amazing era that everything is on the internet. Literally, you can look things up on Google, on YouTube. These are amazing platforms where you can get knowledge for free. Just search anything like how to make money online, or how to do affiliate marketing, how to get dates, how to pull, how to close. Like, all the material, like phenomenal advice on YouTube and Google. Like, I look some of the things up and I'm like, yo, this shit should not be free. Like, what the fuck? Like, so there's insane amount of value online, so you can definitely look that up. And if you want to get more advanced stuff, then you can also invest in paid courses. You know, you can look at cheap stuff like books. These are amazing because with just $15, you can download a millionaire's brain within just several hours that took them like decades of learning and trial and error and failures and success. And also, like, courses, like, it may be a little more expensive, like a couple $100, maybe $1,000, but from my experience, if you choose the right courses, amazing, amazing changes that happen to your life. You can also get real life mentors. It can be someone like Mark Zuckerberg, if you can somehow do that. Or it can be just somewhere like in your social circle or in your local area that's getting more success than you. Like, that's all that takes. If they're getting more success than you, then you should try to learn. Like, buy them dinner, buy them lunch, hang out with them, provide them value somehow. Build commonalities, and then you can learn from real life mentors from there. It's like through osmosis, which is basically just by being around them, you're getting all their knowledge, just like absorbing, like trying to learn. That's how you find out the how. To summarize, what Ray said, are you gotta take massive action and you gotta do the positive reframing. Phenomenal advice. And what I've said is you gotta know the why and you gotta know the how. These are some of the advice that we can give to you that'll help you deal with difficult times. Now, if you enjoyed this video or it helped you in any way, you should definitely swing by Ray's channel, and I'll put the link in the description. And if you wanna see more videos like this, definitely subscribe to this channel right here. All you gotta do is tap the red subscribe button below this video. Question of the day, what is your why? Is it for yourself? Is it for a family? Do you need to make more money? Let us know in the comment section below.